Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. Today we'll be creating this 3D text effect in Photoshop. We have given moist and glossy surface effect to the text. To create this, we'll first draw the typography using the pen tool and edit the stroke thickness using the brush tool. Then we'll add a 3D effect using the layer style option, and lastly, with the help of brush tool, we'll add shadow depth and the highlights. So let's begin the tutorial. Open a new Illustrator document. The first thing we're going to do is to draw the typography using the pen tool. So select the pen tool using the keyboard shortcut P and start drawing out the text. For this, we'll draw out each alphabet separately. To begin with a new stroke, press P on your keyboard and continue drawing the rest of the alphabets. We are giving calligraphy style to the text. Next, select all the alphabets and change the stroke thickness to around 24 points. Now we'll adjust the stroke thickness using the brush tool. So select the brush tool, then click and drag the area where you want to reduce the thickness. This way, we'll add a style to the design. Set the thickness for O, D and Y. Let's make the top portion thicker, narrow here, add a little thickness here and narrow at the tip. Next, adjust the vertices using the direct selection tool. Use handles to maintain the curve. Lastly, do the final adjustments of the stroke using the direct selection tool and the brush tool. And we are done with the typography. Next, we're going to create this effect in Photoshop. So open a new Photoshop document. Set the dimension 2900 by 1700 pixels. Unlock the background layer and apply a dark blue color. Then lock the layer by clicking on this icon. Now open the Illustrator file. Here we select the typography and change the stroke color to white. Now select the individual alphabets and drag and drop it to Photoshop. Place them in their respective position. Scale on the size and let's begin creating this effect. So select the layer B and double click on the layer to open the layer style panel. Here first apply the gradient overlay. Click on the gradient option to open the gradient editor panel. We'll change the left slider color to dark pink. So let's type the color code #A42951 and click OK. In the same way, open the right slider and change its color to light brown by adding the color code #F9AD9B. Next, apply inner glow. Change the color to dark brown by using the color code #45051D and click OK. This will add a depth along the border. Now change the blend mode to multiply. Reduce the opacity around 50%, increase the size to 35 pixels and set the range to 36%. Next, we'll add inner shadow. Change the blend mode color to #60063 to apply dark brown color. Then reduce the opacity to around 68% and check use global light and set the angle of rotation to -114. Increase the distance to 45 pixels and set the size to 21 pixels to blur out the sharp edges. Next, we'll add bevel and ambers. Reduce the shadow mode opacity to 0%. Then under gloss contour, we can choose any of the contour, either double or triple. Now increase the size around 24 pixels, shading angle to 120 by 60 degrees. Choose triple contour for this effect. If you don't have this contour, click on this setting icon and select contour. This will open a window. Click on append to get the contour. Next, set the highlight mode opacity to around 36%. This will reduce the opacity of the highlight. To set the highlight properly, activate contour and choose this curve from the collection. Then increase the range to around 75%. Next, do the final adjustment with the setting and once done, click OK. Now we'll apply the same effect to the other two texts. So with the Alt pressed, click and drag the effect over the other two text layers. This will apply the same effect to the overall design. Now let's do some arrangement. Bring the letter B layer on top and O layer just below it. Next, we'll add more details using the brush tool. So add a new layer on top and change the layer mode to multiply. Now choose foreground color to dark faded red using the color code 722737. And using the soft brush tool with the opacity around 30%, start adding depth to the design. Apply dark color along the lower region. But before we go further, let's change the background color to black. Now with the brush tool, start drawing out the details. To add a partition between two texts, use smaller brush size to draw the outlines. Then with the larger brush size, fade out the sharp edges. Apply dark color along the border with a soft blend. And we'll use soft eraser tool to erase out the darker shades applied along the central region of the stroke path. Use 30% opacity for the eraser tool. By doing this, we are adding brightness to the design. Again, use brush tool to apply darker shades along the border, add more shades along the corners, and also where two shapes overlaps. Here we'll again add a partition. So use smaller brush size to add the details and larger brush size to blend it out properly. Then we'll use the eraser tool to balance the design by deleting out the unwanted strokes. Lastly, do the final touch up. Use eraser tool to increase the brightness and brush tool to add more depth to the overall design. Giving more time to these steps will give you a better output. Now we're gonna add the highlights to the design. To do that, add a new layer. Change the layer mode to color dodge and select the brush by pressing the P key on your keyboard. Next, choose round brush. Change the fill color to white using the color picker and start drawing out the strokes over the top region. But before that, let's click on this icon to open brush attributes panel and reduce the spacing to 1%. This will give us a smooth brush stroke. Apply it over the top region of each of the alphabets. Reduce the brush size to add a thin stroke highlight. Next, use eraser tool with 100% hardness to delete the extra shapes which are not included in the design area. Then do some modification with all the highlighted shapes. Make the round ends little pointed and the others flat cut at the ends. Now reduce the fill value to 59% and add few more highlights. Follow the path of the design while drawing out the strokes. Next, go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Here, set the radius value to 2.1 pixel and click OK. This will add a nice glossy effect to the design. We can add little more details to the highlights by using the eraser tool. With 30% opacity, you can give multiple layers a highlight effect like this. Do this for all the other shapes and complete the final touch-up. Next, type out a text, scale up the size, and place it below our design. We have used SourceScan Pro Bold font for this text. Now double-click on the layer to open the layer style panel. We'll apply gradient overlay and bevel and ambus. Under gradient overlay, change the gradient right slider color to dark faded yellow and the left slider color to light yellow. Then under bevel and ambus, set the depth to 469%, size to 1 pixel and click OK. Next, we'll add a texture to the background. So add a new layer and fill it up with a color. Now open the layer style panel and activate pattern overlay. We'll choose this pattern and scale up the size to around 130%. Then change the blend mode to difference and click OK. Now we'll apply a mask to the layer. So select the elliptical marker tool with a feather 300 pixel. Draw an ellipse from the center with the Alt pressed and click on mask. Now unlink the layer, scale up the size to reduce the mask area and reduce the layer opacity around 70%. Next, we'll add a drop shadow. So open the layer style panel, uncheck use global light and set the angle to 103 degree. Set the distance to 35 pixel, size to 18 pixel and click OK. In the same way, we'll add drop shadow for the text. So select all the three smart object layers and create a duplicate. Then select the individual effects and delete it. This will leave us with white flat shape. Group up the layers and place it below our design. Now double click to open the layer style panel. Here activate drop shadow. Set the angle to around 94 degree, distance to 32 pixel, size to 16 pixel and click OK. Lastly, let's add a color tone to the texture. So open the layer style panel for the pattern layer and apply color overlay. Change the blend mode to multiply and choose a color from the color picker. We'll choose yellowish tone for our design and click OK. Finally, we have completed designing a 3D text effect where we have given a moist and glossy surface effect to your text. We have used few new techniques to get this effect. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.